السلام عليكم ورحمة الله. الحمد لله رب العالمين، والصلاة والسلام على أشرف المرسلين نبينا محمد وعلى آله وصحبه أجمعين. continue إن شاء الله تعالى with the book of إمام ابن رجب رحمه الله، استنشاق نسيم الأنس من نفحات رياض القدس. It's the book about the love of Allah سبحانه وتعالى. And we are in the chapter of the dua to make dua to Allah سبحانه وتعالى to achieve this level of al-mahabba, or the love of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala in the most perfect way. And this is one of the greatest needs, the greatest things that a person would ask Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala for. And we learned some of the hadith, some of the dua of the Prophet sallallahu alayhi wa sallam. So without repeating them again, inshallah ta'ala, and they are ad'iyah for us to learn really and to make dua to Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala to make us among those who love Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. So continuing with these dua, he mentioned here in some of the narrations, and he mentioned the chain of narration from the riwayah of Abi Burda, قال صليت إلى جنب ابن عمر فسمعته حين يسجد يقول. I prayed next to ابن عمر and I heard them in sujood saying, اللهم اجعل حبك أحب الأشياء إلي وخوفك أخوف الأشياء عندي, which means, oh Allah, make your love the most beloved thing to me, and your fear is the most fearful thing to me. يقول خرج أبو نعيم. Regardless of the authenticity of this athar, but it's a dua, and al-asr, the rulings for dua, it's permissible as long as the meanings of it is correct and it's good. And as we heard the authentic hadith from the Prophet ﷺ that gives the same meaning of the dua. Also, Abdullah ibn Umar used to, it says that he كان يدعو على الصفا والمروة وفي مناسك, used to make dua on the Safa wal Marwa and in the manasik of al-Hajj, and he would say in his dua, اللهم اجعلني ممن يحبك ويحب ملائكتك. Oh Allah, make me among those who love you and love your angels, ويحب رسولك and love your messengers, ويحب عبادك الصالحين, and from those who love your righteous slaves. اللهم حببني إليك, oh Allah, make me among those who you love, وإلى ملائكتك وإلى رسلك وإلى عبادك الصالحين, and to your angels and to your messengers and to the righteous of your righteous slaves. So this is again in the subject of the love, because of the love of Allah, and to have the love of those who Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala love in the heart. This is by Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. And everything is by Allah. So to ask Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala for everything and not to rely upon oneself. Also, he mentioned that وروى إبراهيم بن جنيد في كتابه المحبة له بإسناد إلى أبي الزاهرية قال كان داود عليه السلام يقول اللهم اجعلني من أحبائك, والله make me among those who you love, فإنك إذا أحببت عبدا غفرت ذنبه لأن كان غفرت ذنبه something لعله يقول وإن كان عظيما وإن كان عظيما وقبلت عمله وإن كان يسيرا. He would say, oh Allah, make me among those who you love, because if you love a slave, you would forgive his sins even if they are great, and you would accept his amal, his actions, even if it's little. So this is the outcome of being among those who Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala love. And if Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala loves someone, that means he has all kinds of goodness, and one of which is what we heard. He also mentioned here within Isnad an Salih ibn Mismar, قال بلغنا أن الله عز وجل أرسل إلى سليمان بن داود عليهما السلام بعد موت أبيه داود ملكا من الملائكة فقاله الملك. That it was narrated to them. Again, this is from the Balaghat. That means this is not an authentic narration. That it was that Sulaiman alayhi salam, after his father Dawood alayhi salam died, that Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala sent angels. So this is from the Israeliyat. فقال له الملك إن ربي عز وجل أرسلني إليك. The angel said to him, my Lord sent me to you لتسأله حاجة, for you to ask him one of your needs. قال سليمان, سليمان said, فإني أسأل ربي أن يجعل قلبي يحبه كما كان قلب أبي داود يحبه. said, I ask my Lord that my heart would love him the same way that the heart of my father Dawood used to love Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. وأسأل الله تعالى أن يجعل قلبي يخشاه كما كان قلب أبي يخشاه. And I ask Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala that my heart would fear Allah the same way that the heart of my father used to fear Allah. فقال الرب تبارك وتعالى, so Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala said, أرسلت إلى عبدي ليسألني حاجة فكانت حاجته أن أجعل قلبه يحبني وأجعل قلبه يخشاني. Allah said that I sent to my slave to ask me for his needs, and his need was for his heart to love me and for his heart to fear me. وعزتي لأكرمنه. By my honor, I would honor him. فوهب له ملكا لا ينبغي لأحد بعده. So Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala gave him kingdom that it was not to befit anyone after him, as Allah subhanahu, as the Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam said, as the mentioned in the Quran and in his dua. ثم قال هذا عطاؤنا فمن أو أمسك بغير حساب وإن له عندنا زلفة وحسن مآب, as it's mentioned in the Quran. And this is actually one of the ways of making a very comprehensive and a beautiful dua. To ask Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, for example, what the Prophet ﷺ asked Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. This is from the dua of the Prophet ﷺ. When a person says, Allahumma inni as'aluka min khayri ma sa'alaka minhu abduka wa rasuluka Muhammad sallallahu alayhi wa sallam. All I ask you for whatever your slave and your messenger ﷺ asked you for. You get all of the dua that the Prophet ﷺ asked Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala for. And you seek refuge in Allah. وَعُوذُ بِكَ مِنْ شَرِّ مَسْتَعَاذَكَ مِنْ وَعَبْدُكَ رَسُولُكَ مُحَمَّدٍ صَلَّى اللَّهُ عَلَيْهِ وَسَلَّمَ. And I seek refuge in you from everything that your slave and messenger, Muhammad صَلَّى اللَّهُ عَلَيْهِ وَسَلَّمَ, sought refuge in you. Comprehensive dua like this. وعن سلام بن يسكين قال سمعت الحسن. He heard الحسن البصري saying, اللهم املأ قلوبنا إيمانا بك. Oh Allah, fill our hearts belief in you, ويقينا بك, and certainty in you, ومعرفة بك, and knowledge of you, وتصديقا لك وحبا لك, and to believe in you and to love you, وشوقا إلى لقائك, and the love to meet Allah سبحانه وتعالى. وعن عبد الواحد بن زيد أنه كان يقول في دعائه, اللهم إني أسألك أركانا قوية على عبادتك. Oh Allah, I ask you pillars, strong pillars to establish your ibadah. Like Allahumma a'inni ala dhikrika wa shukrika wa husni ibadatik. Wa as'aluka jawariha musari'a ila ta'atik. And I ask you jawarih, physical body, that in haste to your obedience. Wa as'aluka himaman muta'alliqatan bimahabbatik. And I ask you himaman zeal that is attached to your love. And when the zeal of a person is attached to the love of Allah, that means this person is willing to do anything because it's attached to the love of Allah. وعن مرثد بن أبي عامر عن الحسن بن علي أنه كان يقول في دعائه that الحسن, the grandson of the Prophet صلى الله عليه وسلم, used to say in his دعاء, اللهم ارزقني محبة لك تقطع بها عني محبات الدنيا ولذاتها. Oh Allah, provide for me a love to you that would take away every محبة or every love of the desire of this world and its desires. وارزقني محبة لك تجمع لي بها خير الآخرة ونعيمها, and provide for me a love to you that would bring all of the goodness of the hereafter and its delight. اللهم اجعل محبتك آثر الأشياء عندي. Oh Allah, make your love the most chosen thing to me. وأقرها لعيني, and the most comfort of my eye. وجعلني أحبك حب الراغبين في محبتك, and make me love you the love of those who are seeking and they want and they zeal your love. حُبًّا لا يُخَالِطُ وَحُبَّ هَوَى. Love that it's not mixed with any حُبُّ هَوَى أَعْلَى مِنْهُ. Not mixed with a love of a desire higher than this في صدري, in my heart. وَلَا أَكْثَرَ مِنْهُ فِي نَفْسِي. Nothing more in my nafs, in myself. حَتَّى يَشْتَغِلَ قَلْبِي بِهِ عَنْ السُّرُورِ بِغَيْرِهِ. Till my heart is busy with this and over any happiness other than that. حتى يكمل لي به عندك الثواب غدا في أعلى منازل المحبين لك يا كريم. Till my reward is given to you from you in full in the highest of the levels of those who love you, O Allah, the most generous. قال وكان من خيار أهل البيت, وكان يدعو بهذا الدعاء في آخر كلامه. It was from the best of أهل البيت, grandson of the Prophet صلى الله عليه وسلم. And he would make this dua in the last, in the end of his speech, and he would weep. Radiallahu anhu. More of the dua, كان أبو عبيدة الخواص يقول في دعائه بعدما كبر اللهم ارزقني حبا لك وحبا لطاعتك وحبا لمطيعك وحبا لأوليائك وحبا لأهل محبتك وخدمتك. اللهم ارزقني حبا ترفعني به عندك في أعلى درجات العلا في منازل المحبين لك. والله provide for me, give me the love of you and the love of your obedience and those who obey you and those who are your awliya and those who are the people of your love and in your service. Allah provide for me love that would elevate me in the highest levels, in the manazil, in the levels of those who love you. وكان يبكي حتى كاد يحمد وكان قد كبر جدا. And he would weep when he was very old in age. A few more before the end of the chapter, he says, وعن أبي صخر عن محمد بن كعب القرظي أن عمر بن عبد العزيز, عمر بن عبد العزيز الخليفة أرسل يوما إليه. He sent for him one day. وعمر أمير المدينة يومئذ. He was the emir of the Medina on that day. فقال يا أبا حمزة إنه أسهرتني البارحة آية. Oh أبا حمزة, last night one ayah made me not sleep the entire night. قال محمد وما هي أيها الأمير. What is it, oh أمير؟ He said, قول الله عز وجل يا أيها الذين آمنوا من يرتد منكم عن دينه فسوف يأتي الله بقوم يحبهم ويحبونه أذلة على المؤمنين أعزة على الكافرين يجاهدون في سبيل الله ولا يخافون لومة لائم. Which roughly means, oh, you who believe, whoever يرتد منكم عن دينه, turn back away from his religion, Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala would bring قوم, people, يحبهم ويحبونه. He loves them and they love him. أذلة على المؤمنين, humble themselves to the believers, stern towards the disbelievers, they fight for the sake of Allah, they don't fear any blameworthy of the people also. So this is the ayah that kept him awake all night. قال محمد إنما عنا الله عز وجل يا أيها الذين آمنوا الولاة من قريش. He said to him that Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala meant by this the leaders from Quraysh. من يرتد منكم عن ديني, meaning whoever turn away from the haqq, from the truth, Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala will bring people that he loved them and they love him. He said, وهم أهل اليمن. They are from the people of the Yemen. قال عمر يا ليتني وإياك منهم. قال أمين. May Allah make me and you from them. He said, أمين. This is not necessarily the tafsir of the ayah that this is only for these people, but this can be mentioned as an example of those who love Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. But again, how an ayah like this, that if you turn back on your religion, Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala will replace you. Replace you by who? These are the qualities of the people. يحبهم ويحبون. He loves them and they love Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala till the end of the verse. And he wanted to be among them. And that's what kept him awake. He says two more. عن سعيد بن صدقة بن مهلهل قال أتاني آت في منامي. That he saw in his dream. فقال أتحب الله. Do you love Allah? I said, إي والله والذي لا إله غيره. Yes, by the one that there's no one worthy of worship except him. إني لأحبه وأحب طاعته. I love him and I love his obedience. قال أفلا تناديه نداء أوليائه. قلت وما هو. قال قل نبهني إلهي الخطر العظيم من محبتك يا باري النسب. Unless again this is something that he mentions here, that he said it was said to him, oh Allah, make me get the attention of the, or to be aware of the major danger from not the love of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, or something of that meaning. So anyway, so another, the last one that he mentions here, كان بعض التابعين يقول إلهي أعطيتني من غير أن أسألك. Oh my إله, the one that I worship, you gave me without me asking you, فكيف تحرمني وأنا أسألك. So how can you deprive me when I'm asking you. اللهم إني أسألك أن تسكن عظمتك في قلبي. والله, I ask you for your greatness to stay in my heart. وأن تسقيني شربة من كأس حبك, and to make me drink a drink from the cup of your love. وكان من دعاء مريم أم عيسى عليهما السلام اللهم املأ قلبي بك فرحا وغش وجهي منك الحياة. Allah, fill my heart with your with joy from you and cover my face with shyness from you. اللهم أعم قلبي بخوف غشيتك وحيي بحبك. So this is the chapter of the dua, and we heard in the beginning also the dua from the Prophet ﷺ. But the dua to ask Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala to have the love of Allah It's one of the important and the greatest needs that a person should have in this life.